Guys, how's it going? This is episode 66 of Down the Rabbit Hole. This is the sister podcast, the True Crime Lounge, Dark Academia Queen. Just a breezy chat. Just a breezy chat of Sassy Southern Belle. I do have a YouTube channel called Breezyville. You can go and check out. This podcast is actually on Breezyville. And everything, and I do a lot of blog. I've been getting back into a lot of blogs and stuff because I've been trying to focus a lot of my true crime stuff. But if you're new here, hit that like button, ring that bell for notifications. Also, please subscribe, help a girl out. And also, so what is Down the Rabbit Hole? Well, Down the Rabbit Hole is a podcast where we talk about folklore, urban legends, random moments in history, weird history. Just like even random people in history and everything. Like, I'm a history nut, so this podcast is something I love doing. I love going down the rabbit hole and like when I learn and learning something new. Because here's my take on learning: the minute you allow yourself to stop learning is the minute you allow ignorance to set in. Point blank. But this is gonna be a bit of a short episode because there wasn't really much to find on this one, but I really wanted to talk about it because this is an Alabama urban legend that is for both the Alabama and Tennessee rivers. Now, there is something called the Curse of the River Serpent, which I didn't know about till recently. Because I'll tell you guys, so I was on the phone calls. Cause see, my friends Bethany, Mary, Gabby, and I, we have a group chat where we allow for video calls only. I might admit I might flood that with reels. I'm kind of lying. If you guys are watching, you guys know I love you. Just know that. But yeah, and we would talk. Mary and I were talking about urban legends. Can't remember. Gabby was like busy with UAV stuff or something like that. And Bethany, I think, had fallen asleep. The ventral I kicked in. Me and Mary started talking about Alabama urban legends and everything. And I was talking about like this time stuff. And I was like, so I decided to go down the rabbit hole. And I came across this like, okay, I gotta talk about this. I'm down the rabbit hole now. But anyway, but this is something called like where farmers reported seeing giant serpents and the Tennessee River as far back as 1822 when Buck Sutton was fishing at Van Holes in a branch of the river across the Tennessee line where he spotted an undulating 25-foot-long creature. And he told his friends that thing was monstrous and it was a creature I could not see as clear as day. He reported to the newspaper. He reported to the columnist E. Randall Florida in 1993 article in the Spartanburg, South Carolina Herald Journal. Now, Sutton did panic, and everyone who saw the serpent was cursed. As the legend would say, Sutton died a few days after his sighting. Floyd's chronicles, others whose experience mirrored his, such as Billy Barnes, who died in 1827 after seeing the serpent, and Jim Wyndham, who died in 1829 after seeing the serpent. Now, in 1877, reports appeared in the Gaston Times of the sighting of the serpent in the Coosa River, which was a tributary of the Alabama River. And a fisherman reported seeing a 20-foot-long creature with fins slithering along the banks at Ball Play Creek before it slipped back into the surface. Now, Tennessee has a legend about a giant serpent called the Tennessee Terror that lives in the Tennessee River. And the legend began in 1822 when a farmer saw the sea serpent. And that was so terrifying, he died from fear. In 1827, another fisherman was reported being among the shaken from his canoes of a bluish-yellow creature and looked like a giant snake. And over time, the legend grew and the Tennessee River became known as Catzilla, a 500-pound catfish. In Tennessee, now, here's the thing. I don't believe in any of this. But I also wanted to point out, like, some snakes that could be possible or be a connection to this, such as the timber rattlesnake, the copperhead, the cottonmouth, and everything. But I don't know. Do y'all believe in it? I don't. I know I believe in ghosts and stuff, but I don't know. I'm having a hard time believing in this one. But, I will see y'all next time, as we talk about the haunting of Orion Williamson and some haunted cemeteries here in Alabama before we start talking about three of some royal monarchs in history and go back to a place nearby where I live called Jamestown, but I don't live in it. I live in the Nashville Metro, so. But anyway, I'll see y'all next time. Y'all have a great day.